Hello everyone, this is Varaprasad and I am presenting you the daily current affairs which are useful for SSC, RRB and other government examinations. Coming to the first one of the session, the Coordination Committee of the World Intellectual Property Organization WIPO has nominated Mr. Darren Tang for the post of Director General. He is from Singapore. The term of current Director General, Mr. Francis Gurry, ends on September 30, 2020. The post for the Director General will be elected by the voting process only. This organization seeks to develop a balanced and accessible international intellectual property system, which rewards creativity, stimulates innovation, and contributes to economic development while safeguarding public interests. Jeet Singh Dhillon has been appointed as the Director General, Defence Intelligence Agency. His nickname is Tinny. His year of service is from 1983 to present. His rank is Lieutenant General. The unit for which he serves is Rajputana Rifles. His awards are Uttam Yudh Seva Medal and Vishisht Seva Medal. To make corruption-free administration, Andhra Pradesh CM Jagan Mohan Reddy on Monday launched 14400, a citizen helpline number meant to enable people to complain about corruption in government department. PV Sindhu has been appointed as the brand ambassador for Andhra Pradesh Government Anti-Corruption Helpline. The next one is Paytm Insurance Broking Firm has received the brokerage license from IRDAI. The full form of IRDAI is Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. Again, I am repeating the full form of IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. The company plans to offer insurance to products across categories including automotive, health and life. It will also offer customers policy management and settlement services at selected merchant places. RBL Bank has ties up with Zomato to launch co-branded credit card powered by MasterCard. Cardholders can avail benefits every time they use Zomato, company said in a joint statement. The card, which will be available in Edition and Edition Classic variants, will facilitate complimentary Zomato Gold membership and renewal of program every year. IIT Kanpur and L&T have collaborated for research in industrial cyber security. They will jointly set up Center of Excellence at IIT Kanpur campus and conduct research in the areas of honeypot, that is, network attached systems set up to entrap cyber attacks and study hacking attempts, and provide cyber security awareness and training programs to the people. Former Attorney General of India and Senior Advocate Ashok Desai has passed away recently. Veteran Congress leader and former Union Minister M.V. Rajasekharan has passed away recently. He was 91. The next one is, under Western Railway, Ahmedabad Railway Station at Kalupur, Gujarat becomes the first station of Indian Railways to install a walk-through mass sanitizing tunnel. The tunnel was opened following its final inspection by Divisional Railway Manager Deepak Jha. It is fitted with sensor so that when passenger approaches entrance, it starts fogging automatically with WHO approved sanitizer containing IPA and hydrogen peroxide based liquid sanitizer. RBI, Reserve Bank of India, has reappointed Mahabaleshwara MS as MD and CEO of Karnataka Bank for next 3 years. Government of India plans to set up a chain of 20 lakh retail shops called Suraksha stores. It will convert neighborhood kirana stores into sanitized retail outlets selling daily essentials while following to safety norms such as social distancing and sanitization to control the spread of coronavirus. GMR Airports Limited will develop and operate Bhogapuram International Airport in Andhra Pradesh. Over past 5 years, passenger traffic at Vizag Airport grown 21%. So the proposed Greenfield Airport site, which is strategically located on the east coast, and it stands to get benefit from vast catchment area surrounding the region. IMF Chief Kristalina Georgieva has named Raghuram Rajan in her external advisory group. He was former RBI governor, who is currently working as a professor at prestigious University of Chicago. The full form of IMF is International Monetary Fund. Coming to the next one, India's public service broadcaster Prasar Bharati has launched a new channel named DD Retro. This channel telecasts all old classic hit shows as its viewership top charts. Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog, NIC, launched CollabCAD in Atal Tinkering Lab Schools. This CollabCAD is a collaborative network enabled which provides a total engineering solution from 3D product part, assembly, 2D drafting, scripting, visualization, simulation, analysis, workflow, and ERP. Center for Monitoring of Indian Economy says that India's jobless rate hits 23.4% amid COVID-19 lockdown. IIT Bombay researchers developed digital stethoscope. This enables noise filtering, sound amplification, recording and playback, and visual representation of heart and lung sounds, which makes the doctors find the problem as quick as possible and give appropriate solution. India's first remote health monitoring system set up in Rishikesh by AIIMS. A website and mobile application were also built as a part of this system. The patients can use these resources to inform doctors about their illness sitting at home. The system also provides monitoring kits to the patients when they are suspected of COVID-19. Coming to the last one of the session, Indo-US IUSSTF to address COVID-19 challenges. The full form of IUSSTF is Indo-US Science and Technology Forum. Thank you everyone. For our further updates, please subscribe to our channel. Please suggest your valuable suggestions in the comment box below. This is Varaprasad signing off for today's session.